So you can see the different environments start to take place. Oh, there's some pictures, you know, hey, maybe his picture, his wife, his girlfriend, his friends, or whatever. You know, tell a little history. Everywhere you go as a player, especially today's game industry, there's so much details you can fit into these worlds now. So there's a little handgun drawn in quite bad perspective. Doesn't matter. You know, it's trying to hold the space. But anyways, today's world, you can fill so much detail, and you want the players to really be immersed in worlds like this, right? So you want to put in all these little elements that are from the real world into your game world. So, like I said earlier, pretend you are there. Little toolbox, just various things you'll use, right? Again, these things are drawn out of perspective as well to create a little bit sense of chaos. More boards, sandbags. The window there is all broken, so it looks like a battle's been taking place there a long time ago, or or every day is a battle living here, right, in this world. An upstairs area, maybe he uses that for storage, so I put some boxes up there, which also for players are really cool because you explore his bedroom, maybe take his TV or whatever, use his bench, modify your gun, then go upstairs and ramble through all his equipment. You know what I'm saying? So all the game players watching this will know exactly what I'm talking about. But if you're more of into films, it's the same kind of thing. You're trying to tell a story with these shots. Notice already I drew a little light on the upper right there, right? So same thing, even lighting. This way, when the 3D modelers built this set, they also have an idea how to light it up. So you can see that the church thing below it is almost gone. It's not really there. So, but it's still taking place in the same environment. It's taking place in the same volume of space, right? That's the important thing here. So if we want to turn this into a real set, we can. We just do exactly what's in this drawing, knock everything out into the background. Here's a little vehicle. I figure this guy's an engineer, he's a fixer-upper, he's a mechanic, he has a vehicle. But it's a waste to park a vehicle in a world like this outside where it could be stolen and not being used. So I think, hey, maybe he parks this thing inside when he's at home or when he doesn't want to get it stolen. And at the same time, he uses the vehicle as a computer as well as a power source. So here I am designing this little vehicle. Just a quick, I turn the background from white to gray, that way I can see my drawing better. And this also gives you a clear view of the building that's actually underneath, right? So here it is, the vehicle itself. Designed as very thin, kind of robust looking, those bank transport looking vehicles, except it's kind of about half the width. So it looks kind of neat. So in an image like this, you're kind of playing all sorts of roles. You're wearing many, many different hats. You are a environment designer, you are an architect, you are a vehicle designer, and you're a home decorating. You got to do all those things at the same time. But that's also the fun part of our job. You never get bored. You're doing so many different things. So just a vehicle, very small wheels. It's not a military vehicle, so it just, it's a service vehicle that this guy happened to have. Better put some headlights on there, otherwise it makes no sense. Ah, there's the headlights, right? Some lights. Try to make it look kind of slow and dopey, right? I don't want this vehicle to look like some kind of hardcore supermarine military kill you vehicle, right? The purpose is to sell the story that this guy obviously is not a military person who's living here. He's just trying to make it by day, fixing stuff, Couple more headlights, little door to access it. It's really fun because you get to design so many different things in an image like this, right? So the vehicle on its own is also quite neat. You could take it out of context and have the 3D guys build it, and maybe you could then litter around all over the place in the rest of the game. Right? Just change the color, change the texture, then you have a asset basically that the map developers and the makers could use to generate the levels. Little window. As I take another sip, I know it's rude to be drinking while doing this video, but otherwise I'll be coughing like crazy doing this, right? So I think one of these, somewhere around here, I'm gonna start opening the little vehicle you see here up to reveal the battery pack inside. Here I am doing it right now. So this again, this is done in front of our students. This is actually, I think, second term students. So I was actually drawing this live for them. So I was talking and making stuff. I never start class knowing what demo I'm gonna do. That's actually the style I like to teach, which is we start some blank and then I know what we're gonna teach as far as the subject matter, like digital painting, where we're gonna do some matte painting. But actually, what we're gonna paint, what the subject, detail is, I don't know, because I like to keep my work spontaneous. That way, I don't pre-plan it. I don't do it the night before or paint it again, and the next day kind of repeat what I've done. I don't like to do that because it feels like second generation to me when I do that. It's not the true creativity coming out as a design. So in this case, the same thing. We cycle through some black and white sets, and I ask the students, which one do you want to see? They go, okay, how about this one? I go, okay, fine, let's do it. And then, what kind of world do you want to see? Okay, let's do this kind of world. Then that's how we derive at this. So everything feels very raw, because that's how creativity works in the art department as well. You don't design something, go to the art department and design it again, right? You do it right there, whatever the client tells you. So that also gives you the confidence to be able to tackle anything at any time without having to be saying, like, okay, I need like 2 days to think about this and then, redraw it twice, three times, whatever. So what you see is actually quite raw. All these designs are happening as we sketch. So there's the vehicle, the lower left. You see how the panels opened up, and this guy's happened to jack this computer system into the little van to use it as power. So try to make it make sense. Again, it's a video game. It's not 100% real, but you want to create some parts of your design that links it to the real world, so the player kind of buys it. They buy that it could be real. Right? Even though it's all made up. Okay. Just some details here and there. You notice that when I work in all over the place. So sometimes I worked on this van for a little bit, and I cut away and I go to the background because you're trying to let your eye see the bigger picture, so you don't get caught up, making this little van here a perfect little design while the background is suffering. So you can see I'm drawing the awning, and then go back to the van, go to the gun a little bit, work on here and there. So it kind of just go over the place. So here's the original plate, removed it, and that's the drawing, right? So the plate in the background is completely gone. It's not the most high drawing because the second part of this, which you guys will see probably next week, is going to be the painted version, not this line drawing. So, or I show you a painted version of something else. That way you don't see the same thing repeated. But in any case, this is prepared for paint. And whenever I prepare something for paint, I don't make the line drawing super tight. Excuse me. Do 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 do. All right. So the line drawings just serves this purpose to hold the forms until I can paint it with value. That's all they do. So if some stuff is on or off, I really don't care. So here's a quick, just to showing students. If you have this and you have to turn it in, you don't have time to paint it. This is one way to do it. Again, this is not the final. This is just a very quick way to indicate some value on an image. Right. It's very, very quick. Which is you just add some darkness and add some light, that's all. So I reduce the home image down with the multiply layer. And just pick a brush, multiply, and you get a kind of a shadow effect. So everywhere I paint is where the light do not hit. So in this case, the light is sort of coming from the ceiling and from the back window there. So everything else will go dark. So this process only works if you keep the line drawing. If I turn the line drawing off using this process, you won't be able to figure out what's going on. Right. So this is more of a line drawing finish. But it's good enough. If you're working in production, even the original line drawing, if you're in production, it's good enough. People, at least the 3D modelers, know what to do. You know what I'm saying? By adding this, it just helps them a little bit better. But if you want to bring it to a level where the lighting guys and the texture guys could use it, then you have to bring it to a lot more. So here's some initial lighting, right? The bed's kind of in the dark area. That way you can watch this TV and do all that kind of stuff. Pop out the vehicle. Because you got to keep in mind what the player will see when he sees this environment. So when you first step in, you'll see the workbench, you'll see the little vehicle, you'll see the storage area above it, and then you'll scan to the back into the background, you see the little window. So right away the player has a awareness of what's happening in this space, so they could prepare themselves for whatever's going to happen next. You know, it's like, should I go stand next to that little fence by the workbench just in case enemy starts pouring through the window? Or should I run upstairs and go steal all his stuff in the storage area right there, right? You just saw me zooming in there. Or should I see if that vehicle still works, unplug it, and then try to drive it away? And that's where the game designers could come up with a story.